Okay, everyone, so this is my polyfil. There are many different kinds in the market, so I actually don't see a difference, but there are people who actually use the pure cotton one. This is polyester. It's a bit more bouncy. Okay, but some people prefer to use the cotton ones because they want it to be organic. So how we're gonna fill this up is, do not try to, you know, stuff this whole thing inside. What I usually do is I'll just, you know, tear it out a little bit first, you know, fluff it up a bit, and then take your potato, flip everything out, and then slowly fill them up. All right. Of course, you have to, you know, fill up with quite a fair bit. If not, then your potato will look like it's drying up. you don't want your potato to look like it's drying up. But at the same time, don't overfill it, because then, you know, you will actually, as much as we try to be very, very tight when we actually crochet, but if you fill it up with too much cotton, I mean too much fillings, it will actually show through the gaps, I mean the holes of the crochet. So I'm just going to continue stuffing it in. When you stuff in the fillings, please just take note that, so that's what I always say, pull the last stitch to have a fair bit of hoop, so that it loops, so that, you know, you won't accidentally pull it up. And then I'm just going to, you see, that's the reason why your tail ends just now, and also the ends of the embroidery of the eyes, you can actually leave it there, because once you stuff the cotton inside, I mean the fillings inside, it actually won't be able to tell. So you can see that my little potato is actually getting fatter, but you see, the moment I press this, can you see it? It's still going pizza, going down. So we need to fill it up a bit more, give it a bit more meat. But of course, please don't overfill. You can see, like those custard horn, right? The bread, sorry. So anyway, so now you can see that, you know, when I press down, it doesn't really go, you know, flat and doesn't bounce back. So we are almost there. As you can see, I didn't fill it up until, you know, it's exploding the, I mean, you can't really see the fillings from the stitches. So this is right. And then we are going to continue with row 22. So like I said just now, we're going to do a decrease right from the first stitch. So you got to be a bit more, this one, please look carefully, and I try to go as slow as possible. So let me tighten this first. And then I'm going to take out the marker, and then I'm going to do a slip stitch as usual first. Okay, the slip stitch and the standing stitch is something that it's for every row. So, and then please remember to actually pull it tight so that, you know, it close up the gap. If not, you will end up with very, very big gaps at the joints. And that's where the cotton, the fillings will actually show. So the slip stitch is done, and then we're going to do the standing stitch. And then here comes the fiddly part. This is my first stitch, and this is my second. So you, okay, I try to show you. Hook up the, it's going to be, hook up the first stitch. Okay, and then the second. Okay, so I got the first two together, and then I'm going to pull through the loops and then crochet as per normal. So this is my first stitch. I'm going to mark it first, because, you know, as you decrease in this one, it's going to be quite difficult to tell the end. Okay, so I'm going to do the next one, which is also a decrease. One and two. Okay, you will find that this row seems to be a bit more fiddly, because it's the last row already, so the it's very tight in terms of the you have your crochet hook, you know, and then this thing you're working with is actually quite a tight space, plus you have filled it up, so it tends to get a little bit difficult. But you have to fill it up, because imagine, with such a small hole, it's going to be very, very difficult to fill it up to your heart's content. end. You see, this is my first stitch, my standing stitch, my slip stitch. So there's only, we're at the last decrease, okay? So tighten, and then one. Two. Okay. And then pull through. Okay, we are done. So what happened is that, so now let's count. I mean, actually at this stage it's not that critical anymore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are still on the right track of 8 stitch. So what is this? This is to tell you how to actually finish it off. Slip stitch to the first stitch in the round, which is what we have been doing, and fasten off. So this time we're gonna pull it off. So let me show you. So where's my first stitch? This is my first stitch. I'll take out the marker and then tighten. Always remember to tighten every time when you're going to do a slip stitch, okay? And then I'm going to pull through and then pull through. Okay. And then what we're going to do, what it says is that fasten off. So what you can do is actually now endless pulling, like magic, you know, those magician pulling out scarves from the So I'm going to pull to like probably something like the reef of the A4 size paper, and then so it's double, okay, double the length. I'm going to snip it off. Please be careful which line you're snipping it off. So you see this one, it pulls, and then you can see down here is moving, right? So this is the part that you should actually cut, not this one. This is your, this is the beginning of the tail. If you cut here, you only left this small little tail and there's nothing you can do. Then you have to connect. Of course, if you accidentally cut it, don't panic. All we need to do is to, you know, tie a knot and extend it and continue with the closing. So it's not the end of the day, so do not need to panic. So what it means is leaving a tail to actually for weaving in. Using the tail, go over and under the stitch in the last row and pull the tail to close the hole. So we're going to use this. We're going to use the needle. For this kind of, for this part, right, using this plastic needle is actually more advisable. Only because it's bigger. So going, what did it say? Going over and under. So it there's no right or wrong. Oh, by the way, you got to see whether you fill it up. I mean, I have filled up my potato pretty much to the liking of myself. So what we're going to do is put through the needle, through the V. Take it out. And then go to the next stitch and do the same. And then you're just going to pull tight as you can. Okay, I'm going to use my needle, poke the... Okay, so do not panic when you see that you still have a gap. So what you do is go, so you do a crisscross. And then you just have to do, it's like a cross. Can you see? So it's like a spider web. Ta-da! And then you don't have the hole anymore. So after that, you're going to put through the middle, go over, you know, go all the way in. It's either, what I like to do is go all the way to the top. Okay, to the top. But you can actually do it at any of the sides, okay? It doesn't matter. The whole idea is to actually go through the cotton fillings to hide my ta-da, like Teletubbies. I'm gonna pull it through. Okay. and then I'm going to you can actually go through the same hole. It won't come out, you won't undo whatever you have done, because there's polyfillings inside, and then it won't allow for it won't come out anymore. But so then the next thing is actually just to bring the needle up from anywhere you want. The whole idea is actually just to hide the, but of course you don't pull too hard, if not then you will end up with so what you can do is you're going to fluff up your potato. So you're just going to do it a few more times to just hide the tail. Of course you can cut it, all right, you can cut it at any, after like maybe one or two times of pulling the thread, the yarn through the body, you can actually cut it. So what I like to do is actually I'll pull it slightly, pull it taut, and then cut close, but not, don't need to be so close until you know you end up cutting the potato, snip it off, and then the moment you finish, you just have to press and then it will go back inside. If it doesn't, what you need to do is use your needle and then actually poke it in. And then there's it. That's the potato, and you're done. So this is the end of the tutorial for the body of the potato, and we will hopefully get to the part about doing the hands and attaching it to the body. We'll see you again. Bye.